guys. God bless. Welcome back to my channel. I am Charlene and I owe you guys an update on my to-be reads for this year, in the beginning of this year, rather. I started out by grabbing 1, 2, 3, 4 books that I wanted to consistently read. And of course, my consistency is not daily, but whenever I have time to read these books and finish them. And so far, that method has been proven better than giving myself this stern, you should be reading this book every single day. But anyway, there are some changes that's going to take place from here on out in regards to how I read. And I'm going to talk about that a little later. So please, please don't miss that. Stay tuned, please. But let's talk about why we're here. We want updates on what I've been reading, right? Let's start with the novel. This novel is called Childless. I got this novel when I was about 19, 20 years old, and it was in Dollar Tree. I used to be really heavy in Dollar Tree looking for books to read because they were affordable and it was convenient because you go in Dollar Tree anyway. But anyway, surprisingly, this was published by a Christian publisher, Faith Words, and it is a pretty good book. I never finished it, and I've been looking and reorganizing my books and things, and I'm like, I'm going to read this and I'm going to finish this. So last time I touched this book, I stopped on chapter 4. I am happy to announce I am currently on chapter 10 and I plan on reading more. So far, so good. I'm not going to do any spoilers in case someone's trying to look this book up or go find it. But I would say that it took a while to make a point to discuss anything faith-based or Christian, which had me like, okay, but it's a clean read, so you don't have to worry about reading anything disgusting or anything. But I find it very interesting, and I can't wait to see what unfolds. This book, Mystery of the Ages. This book, I was so excited and felt so leveled up to even pick this book up. I was like, wow, this is a heavy book. Got 300 some pages. I got a lot of chapters. Different concepts. The Mystery of the Ages talks about those heavy conversations about God, tithing, angels, demons, churches, early church history, other concepts, the universe, all of that is in here. Humanity, why you exist, what's your purpose, like really heavy hitter. So much so that before I had Isabella, I had taken time to read through the introduction, which I hardly ever do, but something was like, read that. And I did. Now, already, I feel like, yeah, this book definitely is heavy, but I felt the need and necessary thought to proceed with caution, and someone even commented and let me know the same thing, like, be careful. So I tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to put this book to the side. It's not to the side, but I'm not going to make an obligation to read that because I was, but not no more. Now this one, The Power of Holy Habits by William Henson. It discussed things such as prayer, giving, fasting, worship. It touches those fundamental foundations of what it means to be a disciple of the Lord. Love this book. It is so simple a child can understand, and it just reiterates what we should already know based on God's holy word, which is we are to pray, we are to worship, we are to gather, we are to give, we are to love, like those fundamental foundations of Christianity. Just reiterate that with biblical background. Love it. Easy read. Only has 10 chapters. I am on chapter 9, so that means I have literally 2 more chapters to go and I will be done, and I'll probably read a chapter today. But so far so good. It is a older book, so I'm not saying hey, go out and buy it unless you're just interested and you're a book person like me. Hence I get all my books from the Goodwill mostly, or like I said, the Dollar Tree. Or every now and then, I'll go on eBay and find a real inexpensive book or devotion. But other than that, I don't really put too much money and effort into books. But I have been on a spree in Goodwills to find books. So that one's good. Then I have the 1 Year Through the Bible devotion. And I was so excited and so hyped about this just to turn around and Like always, it's something about chronologically reading the Bible in order, and that's what this does. Like, it's a devotion, but it also has scriptures on the side, and the scriptures are in order of the Bible. And sure enough, I flopped like the first couple of days of January, to be honest with you. And obviously, once I had Isabella, things went way left after that. I would say this will make for a great book or something to keep in your Bible, because it does go through the whole Bible with some passages, not a whole lot. But like, for example, today is March 9th. Let me go find it. Well, here's March 10th. Okay, so it has a preview, personal application, and then it has the Bible reading on the side. And like for this one, it's 2 Samuel 21, 1 through 24, 25. You know, just a little bit, not a lot. Just some of the scriptures to read. So that would be like with a whole chapter and a verse. But yeah, this didn't work out at all. But it was good intentions. And I would say that I am actually actively reading in my own personal Bible reading plan. So that may have something to do with it too. Because I chose that one because it's not in order. So maybe if they were hand in hand, that would work. Which maybe I'll try that next year. But for right now, I'm sticking to my regular reading plan. Here's a new one that I actually show you guys. A part of my pickups from Ollie. It was $2.99. It retails for $16. The 1 year Daily Moments of Peace Inspiration for Women. And the first day I picked this up and read, I'm like, I have to make sure I read this. So I have been led to pick this up and read this often for each day. So I'm current in this, allegedly. Like, I'm not every day reading this, but I try my best to touch it at least every other day. And so far, so good. You never know when you're lacking something until you actually, you know, tackle that concept, which is peace. You think you're living in peace. You think you are at peace until you really dig inside yourself and you talk to God, and he lets you know that you have whatever it is going on in your mind and your heart, and deal with it. And this book helps me to deal with it. And it's, like I said, early on, like I'm just a couple days in, like, because I didn't get this at the beginning of the year. I got this like a month ago, and I'm glad I found it. So, that's the 411 on my reads and the changes that occur. Please, please watch any further videos on this matter, because like I said, I have a lot to say and I want to share new reads or prospect reads. So, stay tuned. I love you guys. God bless. Take care. Bye.